afternoon and welcome to Audio Tree Live on this serendipitous Tuesday, June 18th, 2013. Thanks to our sponsors, The Music Garage, Emperor Cabs, and Pretzel Crisps, we are so stoked to have in the studio with us today, Mr. Lies. Thank you. Audio Tree Live. We're in the studio with Mr. Lies.
Hi.
Hey, man, thanks for being here.
It's great to be here. Thank you.
Killing it up there. I was wondering where you learned those dance moves from, you know? Just your soul?
It's my body.
Yeah, your body takes over when the music lays down on you?
Sure. I mean, I feel like with electronic music, you're either doing everything up there or you're doing nothing at all.
Right.
And so, like, there will be people, I'm not going to name names because I'm not that kind of person, but there will be people who literally come up here, press play,
like,
play,
like,
throw
away
some D's on that bitch in their DJ set. They won't even play their own shit. And then, you know, they'll just be dancing up there. They won't even bother, like, trying to manipulate their tracks or anything like that. I try to, like, come with, like, the most intriguing electronic music, like, I don't know. I saw, like, Magical Clouds at the Metro open up for Youth Lagoon, my friend Devin. And when he's performing live, I mean, it's just a very minimal setup. It's a guy behind, like, a sampler and a couple, like, effects pedals, and then this guy singing. But, like, they're making theater. They're staring people down in the audiences and stuff like that. And it's pretty much one of the most, even though it's such a minimal setup, it's, like, one of the most intriguing live performances I've ever seen. So, or there's a guy like Nico Jarre who performs with a band, or James Blake. And hopefully with my next record, I'll try to do something until that. But until then, I'm touring on my own with my controller.
Because you play instruments, correct?
Yeah, sure.
And on your album Mowgli?
Yes.
Which is awesome, by the way.
Oh,
I spun it a few times.
Thank you.
Yeah, man. You have a bunch of credits for lots of musicians that you brought in for that, and lots of instruments that you play yourself, right?
Mm-hmm.
Cool, man. I was wondering about kind of you spoke that you do DJ sets occasionally, but that you preferred producer or musician for your own title. You know, I was wondering of that relationship kind of between you and, as you said, your friend, other DJs or other electronica musicians or other, you know, whatever. Like, do you hang out with them like bands do? I mean, when you're on tour, like, you guys go out and get beer together or whatever?
Oh, yeah, sure. I mean, I just went on tour with Giraffage and Slow Magic.
Sweet.
In Europe. I know Slow Magic was here, like, not too long ago.
Yeah.
And what was interesting about that is that we all have, like, very different vibes as far as our music goes. Slow Magic's music is very bright and upbeat, whereas mine can kind of go to the dark side. And then Giraffage has got, like, he's, like, very banger heavy.
Mm-hmm.
And for some reason, we still have, like, the same vibe and, like, the same intentions with our music. We've been trying to do, like, the live band thing for ages, but it's, you know, it's just about development and things like that. And I respect those two guys immensely for the music that they do. It's like with this whole, like, bedroom community scene, it's like the mean age of producers is certainly getting younger.
Okay.
I'm 20 and I constantly kind of get sort of I get a lot of attention for, like, my age, like, in interviews. Mm-hmm. People are like, oh,
can't believe you're only 20.
Yeah,
or
can't believe you're not even, like, of drinking age. And, like, you know, like, the funny thing about that is, like, while that might be true, like, take a look at someone like my buddy Marcel, XXYYXX. He's about 17.
Oh, geez.
And, like, it's only getting, and, like, with that amount of, I could not imagine being, like, his age and, like, trying to do what we're doing now.
Yeah, like going to Europe or doing anything
getting
that
amount of attention and just, like, seeing, you know, how the crowd reacts to his music. It's, like, he's beyond his years, like, absolutely. But I don't think it's necessarily about, like, the youth that's kind of a huge part of this electronic scene as much as it is, you know, these kids have really good ears.
Okay.
Throughout this whole thing, a lot of people, like, blame that on the internet, but I think it's just, like, as technology advances, as music advances, people are learning more things. I know Marcel's a really good guitar player.
Cool.
For example. So, are you getting me? This, like, mic is, like.
Yeah, yeah. I can hear you well. I hope those guys are
cool.
The internet.
Can you guys hear me?
Well.
Internet, can you hear me?
The internet, can you hear it? Yeah, man. Yeah, for sure. Do you want to move into another track?
Sure. Yeah, I'll do that. I'll play.
We're here with Mr. Lies, Audio Tree Live.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Lies on Audio Tree Live, laying down the tracks for us here today.
Hi.
Thanks again, man, for being here.
No problem. It's really great to be here.
Hey, so specifically the track Kanan on Mowgli.
Yeah, sure.
It's mostly lyrical for those who haven't heard it. It's a girl, a friend of yours, I assume?
Yeah, she is a friend of mine who I went to high school with. Her name is Julia DeRay, and she's actually an acting major at Northwestern. I'm about to actually go grab a drink with her after the show tonight at Shuba's. So
cool.
It's been a while since I've seen her.
So that song is her, and you said like a field recording, or at least you have it on the credits.
Yeah, I asked her to do a field recording for me because I was up in Vermont doing the record. Most of the collaborations on Mowgli, I actually recorded a majority of it alone, and the horn player that I had on there, and then Alexa from Exit Music, who sang on Hounded.
Yeah.
All those people, I kind of just did work by email, kind of postal service style.
Okay.
And with Julia, the actual like lyrics to Kanan were written by our friend Peter Lasorenza, who's like an amazing writer. He's doing his undergrad at Fordham in Brooklyn right now.
Cool.
And like just the whole poem is kind of like about like being like young in the suburbs and kind of feeling trapped in a sense, and
right,
wanting to travel and wanting to like move. It's kind of that whole feeling of Mowgli, like here's this kid who was you know, raised in an environment he clearly didn't belong in, and then he discovers like the man village, like mm-hmm, when he grows up, and he's like, oh shit, this is what I've been missing this whole time. So it's like sort of feeling of disillusionment,
sure,
and like, you know, like 20-year-old existential crisis-y sort of.
Yeah. Quarter life crisis.
Like pre-midlife.
Yeah, exactly.
Crisis sort of thing. And so I had Julia, basically, I asked Peter if I could use it because it inspired me a lot. And Julia recorded it on her iPhone, like under a tunnel where we used to hang out as kids. And so I got it back from her and I decided to use it. And it's so funny because like, you know, there are certain reviews of the record. I don't read a lot of press, but like,
you try not to.
I try not to,
yeah,
at least.
I think,
but
that's
like
important.
I saw one review once that said like Kanan is right out of a AP senior English notebook. Like and I was like, you know what? That's funny because it actually
yeah, somebody nailed it spot on.
Yeah, I was just like they were trying to like review, like they were like criticizing that, but like it's actually the truth.
Naming
which is,
a
which
fact,
which is always funny, but you know, fuck reviews.
For sure. I was wondering what your feelings on lyrics in electronic music were, because clearly you included that because it inspired you, and some of your music does have lyrical influence or has lyrics in it, actually. Mm-hmm. Where do you think is the balance there, or do you think they help or do you think they hinder?
I think you know, you want to try to use them minimally.
Okay.
In terms of, well, I guess it's based on which, it's kind of like a funny subject. It's kind of like a loaded question.
On the
next record, I'm going to be singing on it a lot more, kind of like I did at the beginning of my set. And I'm going to start, I have to start thinking a lot more about lyrics. I'm actually, when I start writing it, I've kind of decided to give myself the restriction of starting on actual instruments, writing it, and then separate, and then like sort of divorcing the writing process from the recording process.
Okay.
But as far as like certain kind of electronic music, especially like the beat scene, I think that should, you know, sort of speak for itself. I mean, obviously no one is really, there are no like people on YouTube who are like, wow, these lyrics are really fantastic,
right,
or anything like that.
Yeah,
it's
really
just kind of, they go for the gut feeling of the instrumental first.
Okay.
But I suppose it really depends on what you listen to. I don't listen to a lot of electronic music as it is. Like on the tour, like I was listening to like American Football and Talk, like,
okay,
almost exclusively. So like, I don't know. I really depends. It's like, for electronic music, it's like similar alley, different rats. Like it's going to change depending on who you are or where you're at musically.
Cool.
I suppose.
Right, man. Do you want to move on into your last bit there?
Yes, I would love to.
Audio Tree Live with Mr. Lies.
Thank you guys so much for having me.
Absolutely, man.
Thank you.
Audio Tree Live with Mr. Lies.
Thanks, guys.
Shuba's tonight at 9 p.m.
Yeah, you, with Giraffage and GTW.
Awesome. Mowgli, get Mowgli. Go to his Bandcamp. You can get it on your Bandcamp.
Yeah,
on
your, you can get it on iTunes, Spotify.
On the iTunes, on the internet.
Records. Shout out.
Awesome. They're going on a North American tour, June and July 2013. You and Giraffage.
Yeah.
Killing it. Thanks again, man, for coming in.
Thank you so much.
Thanks to Emperor Cabs, Music Garage. Thanks, Pretzel Chris, for bringing an awesome spread today. Thanks to the viewers for checking him out. If you enjoyed the session or just want to give connect with us or the band, please extend your gratitude via Twitter or Facebook, and be sure to check out the other awesome sessions at audiotree.tv. Bye.
Woo! Nice.